Well, ahead of the president's big speech tomorrow, the Republican is already questioning whether it's worth all the hullabaloo today. Wyoming Senator and Dr. John Barrasso, not a bit impressed by one thing he's heard thus far. But, Senator, you're going to be there for it, right? A lot of your colleagues are not. In fact, an unusual number are not. What do you think of that?
Well, I'm going to be there. I'll encourage my colleagues to attend as well, Neil. But I don't know what the president's going to say. You know, you look at what he's done so far, and I want to make it easier and cheaper to create private sector jobs in this country, and it seems that his policies make it harder and more expensive to create private sector jobs. I mean, he has thrown through his regulations and his taxes and his plans a heavy wet blanket over our economy.
You know, whether he takes his cue from the Democrats who sit on this super committee, this gang of 12, who are going to settle out the remaining $1 trillion or so in cuts that have to be made in the next tranche of that debt measure. A couple of them might be a bit of an eyebrow raiser here. Among some of the tax reform these Democrats are looking at, Senator, I don't mean to hit you broadside with this, is, closing tax loopholes for hedge funds, trimming corporate tax breaks, managing pay at hedge fund companies, corporate jet depreciation allowances, removing them, and on and on and on. It all sounds like a big focus on revenues. What do you think of that?
Well, that's not the solution to what our economy needs. We need to focus on jobs and the economy. And sure, closing loopholes as a matter of overall tax reform in the country, I think is important. We need to get people back to work in this country. And I think no matter what the president has done, he has made this situation worse. So, you know, he has promised the big speech. I want to see what the specific details are. With the budget and the debt plan recently, we didn't even have anything in writing from the president. He said, well, everybody knows what he stands for. I don't think the American people really did know. And that's why, I mean, tomorrow I'm coming out with my colleagues in the Senate and House Western Caucus with an entire jobs program. And it's actually the Western Caucus jobs frontier, breaking down Washington barriers to America's red, white, and blue jobs. That's what we need to do, get Americans back
Senator,
to work.
Senator, how many pages is it?
It's 20 pages.
Okay, I can read that. The 2,000-page health, that was a monster.
No.
All right, so I can definitely read that.
Anybody who reads this will understand it clearly, and they'll say, hey, they're focused on American jobs, American energy, American opportunities.
But you know, Senator, when the pleasure of meeting you last time was in Washington for that ridiculous soap opera, and that building that you're sitting in was not air-conditioned, I might point out. Of course, you're very thin and fit. You were dealing with it, didn't sweat once. That was then, this is now. And I'm wondering whether this is going to be the way things are done right through the end of this session of Congress and this president's term, that nothing really gets done. And if stuff is done, it's by hook or crook and with a knife at someone's political throat.
Well, what the president has done in just the last 2 months is his administration has proposed and put out over 1,200 new federal regulations at a cost of over $17 billion.
Well, he's not cutting back on them.
Dollars.
The indications tonight,
no,
sir,
he's
is that
not.
He's not. He's not going to do that.
Well, you know, there's a difference between the president's rhetoric and the reality of all the red tape that's coming out of this administration. They said, well, we're not going to, you know, we're going to try to cut about $10 billion of regulations, Neil, over the next 5 years. But in 2 months alone, they've come out with over $17 billion of new regulations. I mean, the president just doesn't seem to get it in terms of how much of an impact his regulations have on the small businesses and the job creators of this country.
Well, you should be encouraged that Robert Redford is mad at him because he wanted to cut, you know, these environmental regulations. He reversed himself. Now Robert Redford's all upset at him. So you should be encouraged.
Well, on the ozone regulation and the president deciding to not proceed with that, you know, I think he has done more good by that than anything he can do in the speech to the country tomorrow night.
Interesting. Senator, good seeing you again. Be well.
Thank you, Neil.